Hi everyone, welcome back to Tech Dudes. In today's video, we are exploring Azure Key Vault, a powerful tool for securely managing sensitive information like secrets, keys, and certificates in the cloud. Here what we will cover in this video: what is Azure Key Vault, why use Azure Key Vault, a walkthrough on creating, managing, and configuring an Azure Key Vault, and a step-by-step guide on connecting and fetching secrets from Azure Key Vault to a .NET application. So let's get started. What is Azure Key Vault? Azure Key Vault is a cloud service provided by Microsoft Azure that allows you to securely store and manage sensitive information like secrets, encryption keys, and certificates, etc. Why use Azure Key Vault? There are several key benefits of using Azure Key Vault. One is it is centralized, meaning in one place we can manage all secrets, keys, certificates, and connection strings, etc., etc. Second is enhanced security. Secrets are encrypted with hardware secure modules, and we can also integrate with Azure AD for access control. Third one is easy integration, meaning this service can easily integrate with other services and applications. And final one is security compliances. It meets all security standard compliances. Okay, now let's switch to Azure Portal and configure an Azure Key Vault step by step. In search bar, search for Key Vaults. Okay, Key Vaults, and select this. And I don't have any Key Vaults right now. Let's create together. Click on create, and then here you need to select subscription. I already selected, and now resource group. I'm selecting my existing one, Tech Dudes, and after that Key Vault name. I am giving Key Vault name as Tech Dudes Demo Key Vault. Okay, now region, we need to select region. I'm selecting this, and pricing tier is standard, and soft delete is enabled, and days to retain I'm giving 7, and click on review and create. It is validating currently. Validation is successful. Now just click on create. With this step, in couple of seconds our Key Vault is going to create. Deployment is in progress. Now deployment is completed. Now just click on go to resource. This is our Key Vault is created. Okay, and inside this you can see secrets. Click on this, and here I need to create a secret. So for that, click on generate slash import. Here I need to give name, so I'm giving as db connection string. Okay, so and I need to give the value here. So for that I'm giving some test connection string value. Okay, paste. Okay, if you can see, that is that test connection string value. Okay, so I don't want to set activation date and expiry date, because this will be useful when you have any secret needs to be activated on specific date, and that secret should end on the specified date. So in that case it will be helpful. In our case it is not needed. Just click on create. Yes, it is created. If you see in the secrets, it is created, right? So now here click on create a new project, and here I'm selecting ASP.NET Core web API, and click on next. And here I'm naming Azure Vault training. Okay, and click on next. Here you need to select your .NET version. I'm selecting .NET 8, and click on create. So with this step, our .NET default API solution is going to create. Now our default web API solution is created. Okay, let's create another controller called database controller. Okay, here I'm selecting API controller, and click on add, naming as database controller. Okay, click on add. With this step our database API controller also going to create. Okay, so see, it is created. Now the second step is we need to configure URL and update the program.cs. okay, before that we need to add two packages. One is Azure Identity. Go to Tools, NuGet Package Manager, and here in Browse search for Azure.identity. So this one, select and install. So directly it will install, apply, accept. Now it is installed. The next one is we need to install security, azure.security. Click on install. So this package also we need. This also installed. Now we need to add key vault URL in appsettings.json. Here enter comma and paste this code. Okay, so meaning that here we need to give our recently created vault URL. Okay, so let's switch to Azure Portal and copy the URL. Copy this and paste here. That's it. So appsettings.json work is done. Now next step is update the program.cs. So here we need to add some piece of code. What it will do, it will get the vault URL from appsettings.json. okay, so next is we need to add one more variable where secret client equal to new secret client. And new URI of variable, our variable key vault URI. Okay, and then here we need to initialize with Azure default credentials, right? So Azure default credential. That's it. Now we need to add singleton for this. Secret client. Done. Now program.cs part also done. Now what we need to do, we need to update the database controller. So let's go to database controller, and here we need to update, like let's say we need to use, what we need to use, we have created secret client, right? So that we need to inject and we need to use here. Okay, clicking enter. Here secret client. Okay, done. Now we need constructor. Constructor also done. So I'm just pasting one of my method. Okay, just add underscore. Now here I will add a method which will be fetching the secret and printing in output. Okay, so I have a method, I'm pasting here. Okay, so what it is doing, it is it is added one, let's remove one. and yeah, now it is ready. So just save and rebuild. So if you verify this, we are fetching the connection string, okay, DB connection string, and we are returning the same DB connection string value as output. Okay, so now let's run this and verify after build is success. Now build is success. Now let's run this and verify. Now click, try it out, execute. Yeah, if you see the connection string, it is serving, right? So it is coming from my Key Vault service, okay? And that's it for today's video. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to Tech Dudes for more web development tips and tutorials. As always, feel free to drop your questions or suggestions in the comments below. Thank you for watching and I will see you in the next video.